In this lesson, we will learn how to modify the colors of our meshes to make them look a bit more interesting. Before we will modify the colors, let's add a box that will represent the ground of our scene. So first, let's add a box. Scale it in the Z and X axis. And let's move it a bit down. Okay, we see our tree is a bit floating, so we can select it and move it a bit down. Okay, now let's select that ground box and open the operations popover. Switch to the material tab and tap the color button. We'll be presented with the color picker. We want our ground to be brown, so let's change the hue of our color and let's make it more brown. In the top of this view, we will see a rectangle that represents the color's saturation and value. And on the bottom, we will see a slider that can be used to adjust the hue of your color. Now let's close this popover and let's select the trunk. Open the popover and let's change the color of our trunk to a different shade of brown. Now we want to change the colors of all the stones. So let's first zoom into the stones, move the camera, select the first stone, and let's now open the selection popover. Let's select Add Selection. Now tap the next stone and the next stone. That way we selected three stones. Now open the operations popover and let's change the color of our stones to gray. Close the operations popover and let's move those stones a bit closer to our tree. Deselect all the objects. Now you see, when we try to deselect, we cannot deselect the stones. That's because we have the add selection activated. So we can just add to this selection and we cannot deselect. To deselect, first we need to open the selection popover, switch to default selection, and now let's deselect by selecting something outside. We have a really beautiful scene now. So we learned how to change colors of our models. Now let's add an effect that will make our objects pop a bit between each other. Open the gear popover and let's select the scene ambient occlusion. Close this gear and now we will see a really beautiful shadow around our objects. You will also notice that the grid has disappeared. Please keep in mind that activating ambient occlusion may slow down your iPad. So activate it only to showcase your scene, and if you want to work on the scene, please deactivate it. If we want, we can activate the camera spin around our objects. To do that, please select the object you want to be in the center. This way, this will be a trunk, and open the selections popover and select Center Camera to Selection. Let's now zoom out a bit, open the gear popover, switch the tab to the camera, and let's select spin. If you want to stop the spinning, just tap the scene.